Hello guys, now today we are going to see the read and write a data using macro program. So in this program we are using main step as macro. So what is macro actually is, it's like a function, okay, right? In assembly level language we have two types of function. One is macro, another one is procedure. Macro will be usually of short coding, and procedure will be of long type functions, okay? So what happens in macro is, every time we write one macro function, then afterwards in the main program, when we call macro, this macro function will get replaced in the main code during execution, so that the execution will be much faster compared to procedure. Now what happens in the procedure is, when we call the procedure proc, we'll use some stack registers to store the address of the next instruction while returning stuff. Like, we'll be using registers for during execution purpose, so that it takes time to travel from this place to this place, again from returning from this place to this place. So the execution speed will be lesser when compared to the macro function. So we use macro for displaying or for reading purpose. We'll use macro function so that it will be much faster during execution. Now in this case also we are going to do the same stuff. So we're going to write the macro functions separately. Like, we'll write one program for one for input function, and one macro program for output function, and another program for main program for displaying the read and write operation. Now what we do in the command prompt, we'll write edit md.asm, and we need to write the program of this part. We need to write md.asm for displaying purpose. Now another, again we have to create a file edit mr.mr.asm. again we need to write this part. So after saving these files, again we need to create a new file, like edit anything you name it as. Like, I name here as str, so name it as str.asm, and type the remaining coding parts. So after creating the three stuff, we'll go for execution. Now initially dot model small means we'll use two segments, that is data segment and code segment. Then in data segment we'll write the labels and how many places need to be used for the during the operation time. So in this case we'll use str as label, and it's a defined byte actually. In last video I've said it as defined bit, it's wrong actually, and it is defined byte. And we're using 80 locations and dupe 0. That means we'll write all 80 locations will replace by 0 value. So in this case, as you see here, from 0 to 79 we'll initialize the value as 0000. So there are some 80 locations in the data segment. Now another location will be going to created as message 1. It's also a defined byte, and we are going to place a string, that is enter string as colon, and it ended with dollar symbol. So we'll create a place for that at 80 location, for example in this case. So we're going to it will get stored as entered string or something. It is a defined byte, okay? So next is dot code. Here the coding part starts here. So start is like a label. So in this part, anywhere if you call loop start or jump equals start, the execution control will be starting from this statement again. So anywhere if you write here, if you write jump equal start, from here the execution will be transferred to here. Again the statements from here will be getting executed. So start move ax add data. So add data means starting effective address of the data segment will be moved to ax register. So for example, I've taken it as something like 1000, so that will be transferred to ax. And then move ds comma ax. So ax will be ax, what it contains, its effective address of the data segment, and that is transferred to ds. Next is include mr.mr.asm. So we have written that macro program in a separate file, right? So in order to include that in this program, so we need to use this keyword as include, so that the we can use that file at any places. Like, we can call so that it will transfer to mr.asm. So it's a keyword. So include mr.asm, it includes the input data files, and include md.asm, it includes the output data files. Next is move si comma offset of str. So offset address of the STR, starting offset of address of the STR will be moved to SI register. So now, as you see here, in this case we have taken it as 00 of STR starting address, so SI will become 00. Read byte. Now read byte means it will get transferred to the macro program. If you can see here, we have written the read byte macro, so this will get executed. So move AH comma 01H in 21H. That is an interrupt function for it's an input interrupt function. Actually we can get only one character, and that one character will be stored in AL register actually. So whatever we type in keyboard, and that character will be stored in AL register. So as for in this case, I am taking it as something like happy. Okay, we are going to type the string as happy now. So initially we will press H, right? So that H will be stored in AL register. Next is move SI comma AL. So AL contains H, and address, what content of at that address will be as AL. So this location 00, before it was some junk value like 00, now it will be replaced as H, right? So because SI value is 00, SI is pointing here. Now next is increment SI. So now SI will become 01, so SI will be pointing here, not here again. Now compare AL comma 0DH. So we'll type some string and we'll press enter. So we'll check it for that enter key. So if the enter key is equal with the AL value, then we'll come out of the input function and we'll go for the next line of execution. So in this case, initially we'll type it as H, and SI value gets stored in H, and then A will be compared to carriage return, that is enter button, and it's not equal, so it will jump not equal to L1. So it's not equal actually, so will it go to L1. So again read byte. So again read byte in under L1. So again it takes the input value as A now. Now again we'll increment once. Initially it was 01 before, so AL is equal to A, and that value will be stored in SI data segment under STR arrays. And then again increment SI, and now SI will become 2 now. After that again that A value will be compared with carriage return. Again it's not equal, so again it will go to read byte. Again we'll type P. Now P will stored in SI here. Again SI will get incremented to 3. Now SI is pointing here. Again we'll compare that P with carriage return, it is not equal. Again it goes to read byte, so again we'll type P. So till we write happy everywhere, okay, we'll write happy. Then afterwards when we press enter button, AL is equal to, now AL will be equal to enter button, and enter button will be stored in SI, and SI will get incremented. After that carriage return now will be compared with carriage return, so this is equal, so jump not equal to L1 we won't get executed, so it jumps to it executes the next instruction, that is load effective address DS comma message 1. That is load effective address means effective address of the message 1, where what it is, here is the offset address, so we'll take this one as effective address, and this effective address will store in DX. So we'll store DX is equal to 80 now, right? So DX is pointing here. After that move AH comma 09H hint 21H. These two lines are the interrupt call to display the entire string. So if there's 09H means it will display the entire string till it finds the dollar symbol. So we have typed here dollar symbol. So as you can see, entire string is colon space. Till there it will get printed in the display screen. After that dollar symbol is there, so it stops the display function. Next is load effective address SI comma STR. So again the SI register will point to starting address of the STR. So in this case we have taken STR as starting address as 00, so SI will become again 00. Next is another L2 label starts now. So move DL comma content of SI. So content of SI is what now SI is pointing at here, right? So SI is pointing at here 0, 0. So content of SI will be moved to DL. So DL will become equal to H now. Right. DL will become H. Now move BL, 0DH. Again we'll check BL value. What is BL value is? Sorry. We'll make the BL value as 0DH. So BL is equal to 0DH. And we'll compare BL, content of SI. So BL is 0DH, that is carriage return value, and SI value is currently SI is pointing to 0, 0, right? So it is H. So it compares with H and carriage return. It is not equal. If it is equal, then it will go jump to exit and the whole program stops. So it's, since it's not equal, it goes to the next instruction, that is display. So that's a macro call. Again we'll go to here, as we can see display is there, display macro. So this statements will get executed now. Move H, 0 to H in 21H. This inter function will display the single character. So this character will display. Now in order to display the any character from using this inter function, this DL should contain some values. Like in this case we have made it as DL is equal to H, and that H will be printed on the output screen. So next, again increment SI. So now XI will become increment SI. So SI will become now 0, 1, right? SI will be pointing here now. After that jump L2. So it will jumps to L2. Move DL, content of SI. Now SI is 1 now. So content of SI is A. So DL will become A. And BL is equal to 0DH. After that we'll compare BL is 0DH, that is carriage return, and SI values, content of SI is A now. So we'll compare A with carriage return. It is not equal, so again it gets displayed on the output screen. Like already it has been displayed as H, after that A. Now again increment SI. Now SI value is becomes 2, and again it jumps to L2. Now SI is pointing at second location, so that SI content will be transferred to DL. Now it's become P. BL is equal to 0DH. Again BL is compared with content of SI, that is content of SI is P now, because SI is pointing to second location, which is at P. So P is compared with carriage return. It is not equal. So till it comes to carriage return, at when SI is equal to 0, 5, so DL will become 0, 5. DL will become carriage, will have the carriage return value, that is 0DH. After that BL is equal to 0DH. Now BL and SI, content of SI will have the same content, like 0, both will have the value of 0DH, so it is equal. So it jumps to exit. So we have written the exit function here, exit, it is a label actually, and under that it will get executed. So move H, 4CH in 21H. It's an interrupt function for terminate the program, and that's the program is all about. So we'll catch up in next video. Thanks for listening. Have fun.